burning, that's right. Hollering, that's right. Yelling, and never stop falling. Right. All because you're too devilish stubborn to obey what I'm preaching.
That's right.
What did he say here?
2 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 4.
What is it?
And they shall turn away their ears from the
truth. They shall turn away their ears
from the truth.
From what's right.
And shall be turned unto fables.
They're doing it now.
Oh, yes.
No, maybe so about it, they're doing it now.
Oh, yes.
Amen. I travel the world and everywhere I go, people turning their ears from what's written. They don't have to be baptized. Don't have to speak in tongues.
Right.
Don't have to believe Jesus Christ is God. Nothing wrong with women preachers. Nothing wrong with homosexuality. There's two gods now. There's three gods.
That's right.
Come on!
The fear of God, right, is gone.
Gone.
There's only a few people in the earth that fear God from the heart.
That's right.
Just a few.
Just a few.
And I'm thankful now that the truth of God, hallelujah,
hallelujah,
is part of that few.
That's right.
There are many thousands that are part of this. Mm. But the fear of God is here.
Oh, yes.
And it's preached here.
Oh, yes.
And it's going to stay here.
That's right.
And nobody's going to take it out of here.
That's right.
That's why I refuse to change.
That's right.
For anybody.
Anybody.
Oh, they have offered me so much. And I always look at the offer and laugh. Right. And I tell them, anytime you can beat what God offered me, I take it.
That's right.
No one came close yet.
No.
Amen. God offered me eternal life with him.
Oh, yes.
If you can beat that, I'll take it. Eternal life with him. No pain. Wipe my tears away. No sickness. Don't have to preach no more. Glory to God.
That's right.
The day of the Lord coming.
That's right.
If you can beat all that, I take what you said.
Amen.
Until then, I'm not enticed or lured or considered by nothing.
By nothing.
Anything you offer me, if it be God, then I think it over.
Think it over.
If it beats God.
That's right.
The being that it won't beat God, I won't even consider it at all.
No.
All right, son, what is that?
And they shall turn away their ears from the truth.
They shall turn away their ears from the truth.
And shall be turned unto fables.
You know what a fable is?
Amen.
Something that somebody have made up.
That's right.
Fables have been passed down through generations.
Oh, yeah.
I remember when I was a child, I heard a whole lot of fables.
Yeah.
When a dove lands on your windowsill, somebody dies.
That's right.
I don't care if you never see a dove, somebody still dies.
That's right.
I was told if you count 12 stars and go to the end of the block, you'll see a casket.
Yeah.
I tried it.
Amen.
I was young, I'd never forget it. Summertime. Beautiful bright night and count 12 stars.
Yeah.
I ran down the Old York Road and looked to my left and right. No casket.
Amen.
I thought maybe it was on Broad Street. So I took off. Ran up the Broad Street. No casket.
Mm-hmm.
Haven't counted the stars since.
Amen.
I was being lied to on both ends.
That's right.
They say you walk on a ladder, bad luck.
Yeah.
A black cat run past it, bad luck.
Bad luck.
Throw salt over your shoulder. That's supposed to be good luck, isn't it?
I don't care
if you throw salt on your head. Either you're blessed or cursed.
That's right.
Eh?
That's right.
I don't believe in luck at all.
At all.
Of no kind.
I perceive that in all things. You are too superstitious.
You're just too superstitious.
That's right.
What is it?
For as I passed by and beheld your devotion.
As I passed by and beheld your devotion.
I found an altar with this inscription.
An altar with this inscription.
To the unknown God.
Whom
therefore ye ignorantly worship.
Wait a minute. How are the people worshiping God now?
Ignorantly worship.
Ignorant.
Ignorant.
Him,
I declare unto you.
That's
it.
Unto you.
God that made the world.
Listen, you ignorant folk.
Yes.
I'm trying by the help of God to get you to see there's one God and Jesus Christ is He.
Right.
And you need to break off your sins and turn from your evil way and repent of your sins and go down in water in the name of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And accept all of God's way.
That's it.
But you're too stubborn.
Ignorant.
Young man, you're too stubborn.
Mm-hmm.
You like it out there, drinking and smoking and gambling and partying and shooting and running the streets all night long.
Amen.
You don't want God until you get in the hospital.
Right.
When you get in the hospital, then you want someone to sing a hymn.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
That's right.
You want your mother to give you a prayer book.
Yeah.
Because you're on your way to hell.
That's right.
She come give you a prayer book and you recite the prayers out the book. You never repent for nothing. You can repeat every prayer that's in the book from cover to cover.
Yeah.
If you never repent, hypocrite, you're going to hell.
That's right.
That goes for you that are here.
Oh, yes.
That are visiting today. Man or woman.
Man or woman.
You have one soul.
That's right.
You decide, you can be your own boss now.
Yeah.
You decide what you want to do.
That's it.
Save your soul or die and be lost.
Yeah.
That's it.
Won't be nobody in hell tough.
No.
You didn't know that?
No.
No, you won't be too tough here.
Tough here.
You're stubborn here.
Oh, yes.
You're hard-headed here.
That's right.
You don't fear God here.
That's right.
When you go to hell.
Oh, yes.
Give me the book of Mark.
Mm-hmm.
Bible said, when thy hand offend thee.
Yes.
Cut it off.
Cut it off.
I want to show you this real good.
Mm-hmm.
Take my time and soak you a little.
In the book of St. Mark, chapter 9, and we're at verse 40.
You that are here, follow me and hear me good.
St. Mark, chapter 9, we're starting at verse 42.
You that are listening, get this.
And whosoever shall offend one of these little ones that believe in me,
yes,
it is better for him that a millstone were hanged about his neck,
yes,
and he were cast into the sea.
Uh-huh.
And if thy hand offend thee, cut it off.
Now, let's break that down plain. And I want you to make that literal.
That's right.
The hand is an important part of the body. I got a better understanding of that scripture, God knows.
Amen.
You can do a lot with your hand.
Yeah.
And when you fail to have usage of that hand or both hands,
right,
it's a miserable feeling.
Oh, yes.
So God says, if your hand offend you,
cut it off.
Offend you, that means this. If there's something in your life as close to you,
mm-hmm,
and as important to you as your hand, cut it loose from it.
That's right. That's right.
I don't care what it is.
That's right.
Live with God, cut it loose from it.
Cut it off.
I don't care how hard it is.
Mm-hmm.
Cut it off.
Cut it off.
Nice.
Now you that are looking and you that are here, you judge.
That's right.
What's in your life that's close to you like your hand is?
That's right.
Valuable to you like your hand is. Important to you like your hand.
That's right.
And you don't want to get rid of it.
Hmm.
What does it mean to you?
What does it mean?
God of heaven says, cut it off.
Cut it off.
Break it loose from it.
That's right.
And you all got something to break it loose from.
Oh, yes.
What is it?
And if thy hand offend thee, cut it off.
Cut it off.
It is better
for thee
for to enter into life maimed.
Glory to God.
Nice.
Now, being saved, naturally, if they're going to bomb a building, and for me to escape, I'm stuck somewhere. And I have to cut my hand off to escape out that building. I'm better maimed. and escaped out that building to have my life.
That's right.
Then they keep my hand and lose my life dying in the building.
That's right.
That's right.
Now do you get me?
Yes. And if thy hand offend thee,
if your hand offend you,
cut it off. It is better for thee. To enter into life maimed.
Enter where?
Into life.
Life
maimed. Amen.
It is for you to be saved